Hi everybody, happy Saturday. It's your girl Allie. It's not 2021. It is November the 12th in the year 2022. So please disregard that error that you're gonna see in just a moment. Hit that subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up. Let's watch Allie's view. Hi everybody, happy Saturday. Guys, today is Saturday, November the 12th in the year 2021, and you are tuned into Allie's view. I'm Allie. I always like to show you guys what today's date is on my iPad when I get a chance, in case someone's watching many, many years from now. Shout out to my cousin Keith. Happy birthday, Keith. Today is your birthday, and I hope you are having a wonderful day. And shout out to everybody else who may be celebrating a birthday today or yesterday or tomorrow or any time in the month of November, like your girl Allie and my cousin Keith just now. Guys, just also Lewis. And a lot of other people. There are a lot of others. Everybody who's celebrating in the month of November, shout out to each one of you. Guys, if you're new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up. Help my videos get trending here on YouTube. Guys, it's gotten a little cool, a little cooler. We got a little bit of rain yesterday and into today off of the tropical storm that came in off the coast. But it's moving on. Right now it's supposed to be Arctic type temperatures here in Georgia over the next 24 to 48 hours, so we'll see how that unfolds. Guys, you may be able to see the leaves moving on the tree back there, and the wind, it is kind of blowing, so I'm going to try to make this brief. Last week was great overall in terms of seeing the stock market go north. Of course, our objective is to try to win going north and going south in terms of movement of options and plays like that. From a stock standpoint, I did not end up buying any stock last week. You guys know my sights are set on four stocks in particular: Amazon, Google, Tesla, and Shopify. Those are the ones that had the split this year, and so I've kind of had a focus on them. Right now I'm still sitting on the two, Amazon, and I'm really excited about those. And when you guys see the progress of some of those call options. You guys know I like out of the money call options, and I have a tendency to kind of hold them, even though I'm learning in the trade and travel course a lot more just about the advanced strategies such as options. And by the way, if you're interested in taking Terry Igioma's course, there is a link in the description for trade and travel and also her VIP portion. I was actually on a conference call with many other members of our community, and Terry did mention that some of the prices may be changing. So just want to make you guys aware. I don't know when that will happen, but I kind of got the sense from what she was saying that there may be some price adjustments, which means they may be going up. There's two parts to the course. She teaches technical analysis trading. Terry is all over social media. She's on the internet, and she teaches people technical analysis trading, how to identify when stocks are in buyer and seller levels. That's what you basically learn in trade and travel. When you get in her VIP part of the course, you learn more advanced strategies, and I have really enjoyed it. The thing for me in my situation is just having the extra cash to really be able to take advantage of some of the strategies that have been taught and that I've learned. And I'm doing a little bit here in this portfolio, but I've got a couple of other portfolios that I use with that course. But this one here, I'm still trucking along and clawing my way, as you guys know, to 100K. Guys, RUNE is sitting at $1.16 right now. It was at $1.63 last week. So I'm still going to continue to hold RUNE. Who knows what will ultimately end up happening with that. Those 90 RUNE token that I've got, I'm going to hold them and just see how everything unfolds. Kind of treating RUNE like I have been with AMC. Luna 2.0. Now, I'm all about innovation. I like to see new and exciting things. Although I do like things, I'm kind of both ways. I want to see new and exciting things, but you kind of get used to the way things are in a way. Think about it. Something new and exciting, and even though it's old now, but the inception of the iPhone. Wow, just think, or the Android, those types of smartphones. Just think about where we were 25 years ago before we even had those things, or before we started using Windows. Just, you name it, electronic vehicles. So I'm all about innovation and learning and being a part of the next wave. At least that's one of the reasons why I want to kind of hold on to these little Luna. Even though Doquan ran it in the ground, and we all, those of you that have been with me, thank you so much for sticking with me, and thank you for joining and hanging in here. But those of us that went through that excitement, oh, we're eager to really see what ultimately ends up happening with Luna 2.0. So we'll see. But Luna is sitting at $1.69 when I came out to record this video, and it was at $2.40 last week. It's really interesting how those cryptocurrencies, of course, the big one, Bitcoin, and all these others, they kind of go right together. And of course, Bitcoin, it is at what, in my mind, I would say, I'm no financial advisor, you guys know that, but it's definitely at a buyer level. I mean, look where it is. I mean, it ran from 19,000 all the way up to, what was it, 60,000 at one point, and now here we are back, what, around 17,000, and who knows, back during the pandemic, back in March, April of 2020, man, it was down like 3,000-4,000, somewhere in that ballpark. So, ha, hope it won't go that low, but if it does, huh, then maybe I'll be able to buy a little bit at that point and, you know, get a little bit as we continue in this range where we are right now. But anyway, guys, not a whole lot going on. You're going to be excited just like I am and have been with KWeb. You'll see that when you look at my portfolio with the Amazon out-of-the-money call option that expires in January, with those Home Depot call options. And you guys know Home Depot reports its earnings, I think, on the 15th. So we'll see what ends up happening. Hopefully the stock will continue to rise with all this sudden change with the CPI report and all that. It was a good thing. Money's been made. Of course, I'm still holding AMC. You guys know that. We'll see what ends up happening. Maybe a gamma squeeze and we'll trigger this thing to squeeze some. And then I can just get off that boat. Anyway, it's your girl, Allie. If you're new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up. And before I get out of here, don't forget my personal emergency log. You guys already know I brought it out. Wanted to show it. This is just a useful resource that you may consider if you are interested in having a place to write down important information that you want to tell someone in case your phone breaks down on you, in case you lose access to your computer. I want to have some of this information written down. It's a little book that I created. It's available on Amazon. There is a link in the description of this video, or there will be when the video gets published, where if you're interested, it's got all kinds of great places where you can record valuable information up to and including your last wishes. What you want whoever's left in charge of your remains to do in the event of your passing when that happens. Also, we can't leave our pets out. Place for the pet information. Service and utility. You guys see the wind's blowing. It's getting a little cooler, getting chillier. Place for your family. Profiles and information. There's several pages for that because you may have several members of your family. Internet passwords. We all know we have a lot of those. Any intellectual property that you have that you want to make note of in here. And like I said, your last wishes. So it's called My Personal Emergency Log. It is available on Amazon. There is a link in the description. And of course, because we like the stock market and we are investors here on Allie's View, you may want to keep track of your trades. These books have the same cover. They are a trading journal. They're both trading journals. They have the same information inside, just different color waves. And basically, here you can record your entry points and your exit points when you get in and out of trades. your trading system and any notes that you may have, you can include in here. There's also a place for you to put your investment plan. And then, of course, the bulk of the book is actually made up of these trading log pages that you see right here. So that's what your girl has. Like I said, this is also available on Amazon. There is going to be a link in the description. It's by your girl, Allie. So check it out. As always, thank you so much for dropping in. And thank you to those that have already purchased one of these books. I really, really do appreciate it. Hope everything's going great with you and yours. And without any further ado, let's look in my portfolio and let's go. Have a great rest of your day. Everybody, here we are inside of my portfolio. If you're new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up. You can see where I finished the week up about $387 for the week. Of course, a lot of that has to do with these different options. You guys remember I got into these out of the money call options, and we're clawing our way to 100K. So far, they're doing well. Of course, Home Depot has their earnings coming up this week. So hopefully great things will happen. Of course, the Amazon call option here has some more time to expiration, and I'm trying to get to $132 and beyond. AMD is rocking and rolling as well. I'm trying to get to 97 on that. It's also out in January. And then you guys remember K-Web, got into that one back in October on the 19th. And you can kind of see, trying to see K-Web get to $35. So we'll see what ends up happening. See how much money we can make off this. I'm clawing my way to 100K, as you guys know. Got the two Amazon stocks now. I'm excited about that. And of course, got the Shopify. And we'll see. We'll be trying to buy some more. All right, so let's go take a look at what is going on with our RUNE. Like I said, RUNE has gone down in its value. It is at $1.17. I believe it was at like $1.63 last week. And like I said before, I'm going to hold on to these 90 RUNE and just continue to see what unfolds. Of course, Luna 2.0 is sitting here in the Voyager app. It's at $1.70 now. That is down from last week. But of course, we know Bitcoin has been down significantly. So we'll see what ends up happening with the Luna 2.0 and how everything continues to unfold. As always, thank you so much for tuning in. If you're new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up. You're watching Allie's View, and I'm clawing my way to 100K. Shout out to everybody who's still in the Chris Sain Challenge. Shout out to Chris if you ever see this video. Let's go.